Shoot is an app that lets you use your phone as a professional webcam for live streaming, video calls, and remote teaching. You use it with a computer and streaming software like OBS or Ecamm Live, or as part of any HDMI video setup or with an Apple TV. If you have a Mac and you want to keep it simple, I made a free USB webcam driver that lets you plug directly into Zoom or Teams. Shoot's basic plan gives you everything you need for a clean camera feed without all of the overlays and other camera stuff that isn't useful for live video, with a lot more control, resolution, and flexibility than you get with Continuity Camera. You can connect over USB, HDMI, or AirPlay, and pro users get NDI support, but we'll get into that in a bit. You get a great picture out of the box, here I am. Even with the front camera, which I'm using so I can show you the controls overlays, usually the controls will disappear automatically so you can just mirror it. We can take full control of our image using these manual controls. We can just go up here, tap, and that gives you full access to your ISO settings, so we can darken the image, brighten the image. We can set the white balance by color temperature, so it's tinted blue, tinted orange, and depending on the camera you have selected, you'll get different controls like focus. You can also zoom, and you can turn on the flashlight if you're facing that way. Anything that the camera can do, you can control manually here. And you can also press and hold to lock focus in one spot, or you can lock the white balance, and anything you can think of. And we switch cameras using these different buttons here, just the 1, 2, 3, 4, and that'll be as many cameras as you have available on your device. And you can control all of these settings from your Apple Watch. So if you need your phone to be somewhere far away from you, you can just tinker with it on your Apple Watch until you're in focus and everything looks perfect. To get Shoot Basic, you can just tap the watermark and that's gonna come up. And here's Shoot Basic. It's a one-off purchase and that you keep forever. And that's actually probably more than enough for most people, but I wanted to try a few more things with it. And that's what Shoot Pro is all about, all the Pro plans. I'll activate Shoot Pro by tapping on the watermark. You can also tap where it says basic or go into the menu, and I'll just grab Shoot Pro. And now we have unlocked all of Shoot's many features. So the first Pro feature is a Telestrator, which lets you draw on top of live video. I didn't know it was called the Telestrator when I first made it. I just wanted people to be able to draw on top of their video, and then it was so popular that I soon found out what it should be called. And this really comes into its own on a second camera. So I have this second device connected, and I can move around, see what I can see, and just draw on anything. This can be used for streaming, or it can be used to connect in a classroom to an Apple TV. If you have an Apple TV in the room, you can send it wirelessly that way. And now is probably a good time to mention that it works with older phones and iPads, going back to an iPhone 6, so it supports iOS 12. And now you can point the camera at anything, just start drawing. If it's moving around too much, you can pause it. Just a two-finger gesture. I can now take my time to draw over this thing. I'll unpause with another two-finger tap. And if you need a dark background, there's a button for that, so I can get a bit more contrast. Double tap to clear. And of course, you can undo. 1, 2, 3. We can just go undo, undo, undo. And that works with a gesture as well. And if you want to add text, say we wanted to pause and add text and say that is a stream, you don't need to write some illegible scribble. With live titles, you can just draw a line and then say something. So you draw the line, speak and hold, and the text appears. So I'll show you how that works. So we'll come back here and we'll go, this is swoop. The size of the line sets the size of the text. So if we didn't have much space, we could go, hello, and make that really small, or we can make it nice and big. Hello. Oh, that's a big hello. And you're not limited to just English. We have a button down here, if I enable it on this one, which lets you change the language. I will press and hold, and we can select all of the available dictation languages. So if I wanted to add Italian, I could just add that here. Close. Now I've got a button for Italian, so I can select it and go, buongiorno. Okay, and that spells it. I don't know how to spell that in Italian, but my phone does, so that's handy, isn't it? You can try the Telestrator on the basic plan, but it'll just bring back the watermark, and you'll have to upgrade to Shoot Pro to get rid of that watermark. The next feature on the list is browser remote control. And what that means is you can control any of your Shoot cameras from any web browser. So that could be on a laptop, or that could be on another phone, or yeah, however you want. So I can turn on the connection. There's a button here. Once that's connected, you see here it is in the web browser. And I can zoom in. We can adjust all of the controls, all of the same controls, light and darken, change my white balance to warm, to cold, and do all of that from any web browser. I can also set presets. So say I had a different zoom level, I'm zoomed in a bit, I want to be able to quickly change that. I can go save new, I can call that zoomed in. I now change my setting back to zoomed out. If I just click load, we're going to be zoomed in again. And we can even make that smooth. And that's nice. And then this also gives you links that you can just use anywhere. So if you want to set this up with your Stream Deck, then you can create a button that calls a link and that will control that. So if you're a streamer, you want some different zoom levels, you can just set that up with the browser remote and then just have buttons to trigger each different level. Next, we have grids. This is great for getting a professional framing. So I'll enable it here. So you see we have a normal grid, but if we press and hold, we get lots of different options, including a Fenwick frame from Office Hours Global. So if I want to line myself up and get my eye line in the right place. If you have an HDMI or AirPlay connection, you can send your phone's audio, either using the built-in microphone or some other interface you have connected, which can be useful in certain situations. The next thing you can do with Shoot is you can actually use the app as a camera and a teleprompter at the same time. You'll need my Beatsheet app for Mac to make this work, but I mean, I love this workflow. So you have your phone and then you have your laptop and you write your script on the keyboard and you're navigating on the keyboard and then you're just able to see the text on your phone. So I'll show you this in action by turning it on down here. You see it wants to do Beatsheet, and if I just connect, we're now connected to Beatsheet for Mac. If I go backwards and forwards, so, and now you can see it's showing the text of the presentation I'm giving right now. NDI is an industry standard way to send as many camera feeds as your network can handle, and this is a great way to integrate Shoot with professional production setups. It also works with OBS and Ecamm Live. Shoot Pro also has a lot of other useful settings and hidden features like a battery saving mode, vertical video support, and I'll show you some of these by going to the settings menu. So we've got our HDMI, we've got different frame rates, we've got a thing called natural framing which helps you use it with an IRL backpack. You can mirror the camera if that's more comfortable for you. We've got all sorts of controls for performance and compatibility. And there's even some experimental features like a virtual green screen that lets you use your depth camera to make a fake green screen, which I've found useful in certain situations. So that's Shoot Pro, which you can download from the App Store now, and make sure you search for Shoot Pro rather than just Shoot, because you'll just get a load of games that way. And for more information, go to shootpro.app. Once you're there, you can join our Discord server, find lots of other useful tools and information for producing live video, including a free online audio delay calculator that helps you figure out if once you're using different phones and microphones, your audio might go out of sync, and this is a really easy way to figure that out. So just go to squares.tv for that. So that's Shoot Pro. It's free to try out. See if it works for your setup. Up and then go from there.